Yep. A lot of dying. I think, so what happens is when you switch planes, it looks like your character actually moves up a little bit. Like that plane right there. Like it's higher than I am right now, but I don't need to actually jump. I mean, it probably just looks higher, just to kind of, just so it's easier to see that there's a plane right there. Oh, interesting. So I can move these blocks. Happen since I can't. Okay. We'll figure this out. All right, yeah, the moving platform's on the back plane. For it to come back now. Oh, I did not mean to do that. It won't let me go forward. Oh no. Let's go back to world map. I don't know what happened there. Luckily, it saved what I got. All right, we're gonna go right this time. I want to get that blue key up there. Yep, this is how this is gonna go. Alright. Got it. Nice. Yeah, strong Fez vibes. What's that thing in the background? It's got a top hat on. Is that a fish? This is a weird game. Awful at this timing. Oh, man. Oh, come on. Oh, I didn't need to face forward there. I did it again. I'm gonna blame most of this on the fact that it's 2:30 in the morning. We'll go with that. Finally. How does one prove existence? Man, that was awful. On my part, that was all me. No entity has retained memory of the great calamity. Thank you. No red keys. Oh, I think I might have to go back to the left side. It's probably where a red key is. So I don't think I can get up there. I wonder if it might be faster to go world map and then go back into the stage. We could, yeah, we'll explore this first area a little bit more, because I kind of passed up a ton of stuff here. I think I went, did I go left? The maker isn't real. There's more of that fish in the in his hat. Probably should not have taken that exit. There was some other stuff there. And then I went this way. Let's go ahead and see if there was anything I passed up. Oh, that's right, because there were the two red doors here. So I've got a blue key now. There's a red key. Oh, and this is, okay. Yeah. Oops. So I wonder how much, like, if there's gonna be, like, a ton of backtracking, like, to go back to previous levels, to get to other areas, and... doing that. Yeah, I, man, this is not even close to what I was expecting it to be. Which I guess is okay, because, like, my expectation going in was, hey, this is a pretty cool-looking game. What, like, is it just going to be, like, a platformer? Like, what is it going to be? I like the music. I like how it looks. I don't know. It seems like it's going for a pretty, like, story-heavy experience. Or maybe not, I don't know, like, it seems like it's going for a very specific kind of story. It's maybe more than you would normally see in a platformer. No clue what's going on right now. Jump while mid-air to smash. Okay. Cool. It's a little bug there. Aha. Oh. Okay, so the levels wrap around then, because this is where, when I went right, this is the exit I took, because I remember there being that thing up there now. Interesting. Yep, and this is, I'm pretty sure this is where, yeah. Maybe? Yeah, but this leads me back here. Okay. We're figuring it out. Slowly. One thing I do like is just how incredibly lenient the checkpoints are. Which I guess makes sense. I could see it getting super frustrating if it was checkpointed in a way that you'd be back, like, if you would lose some progress which every time you died, because as you can tell, it's pretty easy to die in this. And there's definitely a piece of it that's, it's partly my fault, but also there have been some times where it's like, it's kind of hard to even tell if there is a platform in that other, in like a layer back. So what's interesting is that's 54 out of 96 and only 3 keys. So I'm wondering if maybe I can go back there later. Like, I have a stomp now, so I wonder if there's anything that I can use that on. To maybe open up a new area or something. Oh, here we go. Okay. Sure. So I can't fit under there. Alright, I guess we'll come back later. I also like that you can just, you can exit the world map and it saves everything you have. Let's go back to the forest. And we're already approaching the end of the first hour, so we'll switch to something. Original human, if there's anything that you saw that I have that you... that you'd want to see next. I'm pretty much open to whatever. Soon. All right, yeah. I'll do another little run through everything in a second. Oh, I didn't mean to jump there. Mm. This is fantastic. Good. That last one goes like really quick. That was me. There we go. This is where I needed the red key. Oh, maybe it didn't save that key from that one. That's weird. Is fertile again. All right, so there's the end. This is very weird. You could break things if you learn to smash. Yep. Well, since it wraps around. I'm assuming this is probably the room I was stuck on. I'm thinking that platform's probably gonna come from over there. So I'll look at that later. Yeah, I feel like I need to see more to really make up my mind about this. How many levels there are. Can't check. I want to look at these trophies. Junkyard. So it's four. Looks like eight. Maybe some. Three different abilities there. Cool. Okay. Well, that's Poncho. I'm interested to check out more of that game. That is not at all what I expected it to be. So yeah, here's what I got. I got Tearaway. Let's see. We got Rocket League, Dragon Fence Soup, Spelunker. Divinity, Disney Infinity, Dragon Quest, Indivisible, Talos Principle. We'll just kind of go through here. So that's what we're looking at right now. Again, I'm pretty much open to whatever. So, and while we do that, let's see what we got. We got codes, which I'm thinking you might be the only person, at least the only person chatting. So I don't know who's all. Here's what we're looking at here. Capsule Force does have single player stuff. It's got like some challenge levels. So I can run through that. It's pretty cool. I actually have not played Capsule Force multiplayer. I've just never had people over. But it does have some single player stuff. Let's see.